Devereux. Please, come in. It's very nice to meet you, Mrs. Colby. I do appreciate your inviting me here for a drink. You weren't invited. I sent for you. And this isn't a social drink. Oh, well, what is it then? A chance for me to find out why, since I've never met you, I don't like you. Well, so much for frankness.
Oh, I'm always frank.
Yes, I know. Exactly what is there about me you don't like, Mrs. Colby?
Oh, please, sit down.
Thank you.
I don't like people asking questions about me behind my back. A good journalist goes straight to the source.
Oh. Would you say these clothes and jewels are those of your everyday journalist?
Well, anything can be rented these days.
Yes, except intelligence. And I am a very bright woman, Mrs. Colby. Of course, you couldn't know that. We have known each other long enough for you to realize that. But you will, given time.
What do you want, Miss Devereux?
For now, not much, really. Merely to check out in the flesh what I've heard so much about.
What have you heard?
That Alexis Carrington Colby is one of the planet's true natural beauties. I'll buy that now. That she lives in a showplace penthouse. It is exquisite.
Thank you.
You adore the south of France, even though you are prone to seasickness on yachts.
Only small yachts. Anything else?
You were actually expelled from a boarding school in Gstaad. And you worked for several months as an artist model in Hamburg, of all places.
Wrong. It was Brussels, of all places. And this is all absolute trivia.
All right. On a deeper level, you are extremely vulnerable when it comes to your children and totally ruthless when it comes to your enemies. And there are quite a few of those hanging about. It's burned.
Is it?
The champagne was obviously frozen in the bottle at some point.
If the champagne is too burned for your taste, Miss Devereux, don't drink it. The caviar, I trust, is not burned.
I really wouldn't know. This is Osotrova, and I prefer Petrosian Beluga.
Look, Miss Devereux, whatever it is that you're doing in Denver, I suggest that you tread very carefully with me.
Let me ask you, Mrs. Colby, is that supposed to be an implied threat of some sort? Because if it is, I am just as tough as you. Maybe tougher.
Who the hell are you, anyway?
Who am I? You will find out very soon. Very soon. You said this wasn't going to be a social evening. So whatever it was, I enjoyed myself thoroughly. Thank you, Mrs. Colby.
Ciao.
For now.